Hey folks, this is Gabe at Security Baron, and I know you have multiple passwords for all the devices and services that you use. Wouldn't it be great if you could unify that? Well, today we're checking out 1Password Password Manager. In today's review of 1Password Password Manager, I'm gonna check out its pros and cons, feature sets, subscription options, customer support before finally jumping into its application so you have all the information you need to make the right decision. If you'd like to see a list of our favorite password managers, Google Security Baron Best Password Managers. If you have a question about today's review, leave us a comment and I'll get back to you. To kick off today's review of 1Password Password Manager, I want to talk about the pros and cons, beginning with the pros. Now, with 1Password, you get multi-factor authentication, dark web scan, and a travel mode. Now, a couple of the cons are that one, you cannot change multiple passwords at once, and two, you cannot get a live person on the chat. So there's no live chat when it comes to customer support for 1Password. Now that we've gone over the pros and cons of 1Password Password Manager, let's check out its feature set, beginning with its main feature, the ability to store passwords across devices, services, email addresses, everything. So with 1Password, you're going to have to go ahead and manually input your passwords into the vault. Now with Chrome, you actually can export a file and then import a file, but with any other browser, it's just going to be a means of going through and putting each password in. Now when you're going through this process, Watchtower will be able to tell you whether or not your passwords are old or weak or repeated and help you to generate newer and better passwords. So that's one thing to keep in mind when using 1Password is that ultimately you're gonna have a more robust, safe system right from the get-go. Now for even more security, 1Password gives you the ability to create a secret key. This secret key gives you two-factor and multi-factor authentication. Now, on top of that secret key, because you may forget it along with your master password, you can give an emergency contact the ability to grant you access to your vault. Finally, you have the industry standard in password encryption and password protection against cracking. So you're really gonna feel safe inside the 1Password ecosystem. When it comes to storage, 1Password stores everything from your vault locally, but they will also give you 1 gigabyte of document storage. And one thing I wanna note is that you might wanna go ahead and sync everything with either iCloud, Google Drive, or Dropbox. Now, another feature that caught my eye with 1Password is the dark web scan. It will scan the dark web for your credentials and let you know if anything has been potentially compromised. So you can go ahead and be alerted to change your passwords. And the final thing that's cool about 1Password is the fact that they have a travel mode, which allows you to mark devices as safe or not for travel. So you don't have to worry about someone in customs going through all your information. Let's check out the subscription plans with 1Password. Now, right off the bat, I want you to know that 1Password does not offer a monthly plan. You're gonna have to pay annually for access to 1Password. Now, for one individual, it's gonna be $35.88 a year or about $2.99 a month. Now, if you wanna go with the family plan, it's gonna be $59.88 a year or about $4.99 a month. Now, one thing to note with the family plan is you can share password and credit card information, you can make sure what people see and don't see within the group, and you can recover accounts for anyone from your family that has been locked out, and that is available for up to 5 users. In addition to the individual and family plans, 1Password offers business plans. Now you have one, which is called the team plan, which is for a maximum of 5 users, and it'll be $3.99 a month per user. And yeah, that's right, a month. You can actually do the business plans monthly. Now it also has the business and enterprise plans, which can be used for a maximum of 20 users. And the business plan is $7.99 per month per user. While to understand the ins and outs of the enterprise plan, you're gonna have to speak directly with a 1Password customer service representative. Now, when it comes to those plans, you'll note that they have advanced features like VIP customer support and 5 gigabytes of document cloud storage. To get a detailed breakdown of these plans, check out the 1Password review at securitybaron.com. Let's check out the customer support for 1Password Password Manager. Now they have an online help center and they also will respond to your emails 24/7. Now, in our experience, that was pretty much true. We sent them an email and they got back to us within a day. But we would love to see some live chat or phone support, though we don't ever hold our breath for the latter. Now, when it comes to what people are saying on the internet, you'll note that on Amazon, they have a rating of 3.4 out of 5 stars from 20 reviews. And of the 9, almost half of those reviews that mentioned customer support, 7 of those were negative, with only the most recent ones being positive. So hopefully that means that they're moving in the right direction. Real quick, I hope you're enjoying today's review of 1Password Password Manager. If you want to be kept up to date on the newest in password managers, VPNs, and smart home security, subscribe to our channel. We're updating our page weekly. All right, let's get back to the video. Let's check out the applications for 1Password. Now, 1Password, you can find basically anything as a browser extension or as a full-fledged app for Windows, Mac OS, Androids, or iPhones. Now, in the Google Play Store, it gets 4.2 out of 5 stars, and in the Apple App Store, it gets 4.5 out of 5 stars. So let's go ahead and check it out on a Windows computer and on my iPhone 10. All right, here I am checking out 1Password, and you'll note that this is just the web interface. I'm just on the internet checking out 1Password, and you'll note that it says step 1, install, step 2, secure, and how to open your vault. So let's go ahead and open our vault right here on the page. Now I'm inside of the vault now, and I can see various accounts. So this is all my items, various places to look. And if you look on the left side, you've got favorites, watchtower. This will let me know the overall passwords. You got 53 reused passwords, 3 weak passwords, 2 excellent, 67 good, 2 weak, and 1 terrible password. So you definitely want to change this out. And this is what is the useful element of Watchtower, a component of the 1Password password manager. Now below that, we've got personal secure notes, various identities. This is all really useful. So that's our look at 1Password Password Manager in the web interface. Here I am checking out the mobile application on my iPhone 10 for 1Password Password Manager. So you'll see there are a host of different passwords here in this initial page. I can of course go to my favorites. Any recent items will appear here. I can use the different tags, and I can go to settings. So it's a pretty straightforward app. Now, if I'm looking at my password accounts, you can see here that you can sign in using various things. This is my account that I'm using. I've got the general, which basically just lets you look at how you set up the app itself. You can look at my vault, so I can make I have a personal vault. I can make a new vault, maybe for business or for travel. So this vault can be titled travel or business. Then I would just create all those things inside of that vault. Now, if I go back and look at how to save passwords and more, it basically gives you a little tutorial on how to do various things. So that's pretty useful because there's a lot of things you can do with this app, and you don't want to be spending your time trying to figure it out yourself. It's really useful to be able to just use what we have here. Now let's go back to the personal vault, the categories, items, logins here, identities, secure notes. I can add a note, like a new password or a section or just any note in general. Don't forget. Now, boom, don't forget, there's a new secure note here. Then various identities, I can put identity cards, whatever I like right there, and of course, your trash. Overall, pretty straightforward, easy app to use, and I just love the intuitiveness with 1Password Password Manager. All right, let's get to the nitty-gritty on whether or not 1Password is right for you, and I'm gonna be frank, I like it as a password manager. It's easy to use, it's affordable, it has a solid mobile experience, and it has cool features like dark web scan and travel mode. So I'm a fan of this. Now, I do want to be clear that if you want to have something that's going to change all your passwords at once or doesn't have lackluster customer support, then you want to check something else out, because that's going to be the case with 1Password. But overall, it is definitely a solid choice for a password manager. So that concludes our review of 1Password Password Manager. If you appreciated today's video, give us a like and hit that subscribe button. As always, this is Gabe at Security Baron. Be secure.